For most of us, breathing is something we don't think about because it's not something we can see. But breathing is so important. Without, we wouldn't be alive, so it's important to know what it is that we're breathing in. When we can't see pollutants, such as invisible particles, it's challenging to know what's in the air around you. So what exactly are we breathing when we step outside? Unfortunately, it's not always air that's healthy. Air pollution can be defined as the presence of toxic chemicals or compounds in the air at levels that harm a human health and the earth. What causes air pollution? The five air pollutant sources, smog and soot, hazardous air pollutants, greenhouse gases, pollen, and mold. The emissions of these pollutants into the air can result in changes to the climate. Increasing air pollution will make climate change worse. How can we reduce this? Making a few different choices about transportation, like walking or riding a bike, will help reduce air pollution. We can also use water more wisely and save energy by considering alternatives to gas and oil like solar or wind power. Let's explore in more details the five major air pollutant sources. The first is smog and soot. Smog is a kind of air pollution, originally named for the mixture of smoke and fog in the air. It forms when the weather is warmer and there's more ultraviolet radiation. Smog is a problem in a number of cities, especially in ones with a lot of industry and traffic, and it continues to harm human health. What are the main sources of smog? The main sources of smog are cars, trucks, factories, and power plants. Smog is especially dangerous because it can penetrate the lungs and bloodstream and worsen bronchitis or lead to heart attacks. The next source of air pollution is hazardous air pollutants. Some of the most common hazardous air pollutants are mercury, lead, dioxins, and benzene. Benzene is classified as a carcinogen by the EPA, meaning that it's capable of causing cancer. It's a substance that can cause eye, skin, and lung irritation in the short term, and blood disorders in the long term. Either way, it's not good. Where do these come from? Polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, or PAHs, are toxic parts of traffic exhaust and forest fires. People are usually exposed to mixtures of PAHs. In large amounts, they've been linked to irritation of the eyes and breathing passages. Another cause of air pollution is the greenhouse effect. The greenhouse effect is caused by greenhouse gases. One of them is carbon dioxide, which is a common part of car and truck exhaust. These gases have far-ranging environmental and health effects. They cause climate change by trapping heat in the Earth's atmosphere, and they also contribute to respiratory disease from smog and air pollution. Further effects include extreme weather, food supply disruptions, and increased wildfires. When air pollutants and greenhouse gases accumulate in the atmosphere, global warming occurs. Then they absorb sunlight and solar radiation that have bounced off the Earth's surface. Lastly, pollen and mold are common air pollutants. You may have encountered these when seasons change from winter to spring. Pollen are tiny grains used to fertilize many kinds of plants. Molds are simple, tiny living organisms that eat the material they grow on. Mold can be almost anywhere, including in the soil, on plants, or on rotting wood. Mold spores float in the air, much like pollen, making them super easy to breathe in. These allergens are influenced by climate change and can be hazardous to health. They're not regulated by the government and are less directly connected to human activities, but they can still be considered air pollution. Pollen allergies are worsening because of climate change. The symptoms of pollen allergies include runny noses, fevers, itchy eyes, and other symptoms. Have you discovered anything about the air that we breathe on a daily basis that you don't want to breathe in? Here are some ways that we can help reduce air pollution. Every time we drive to school, use our heaters or air conditioners, clean our windows, or even style our hair, we're making choices that affect air pollution. These steps, and many others, are things that all of us can do to help reduce air pollution. Make good choices about transportation. Ride a bike or walk instead of driving, or take public transportation. For driving, choose cars with greater fuel efficiency or choose an electric car. Conserve energy. Request that your electricity be supplied by wind or solar. Buy food locally. This cuts down on the fossil fuels burned in trucking or flying food in from across the country. What step are you going to take to help reduce air pollution and to help make our planet a healthier, cleaner place for your lungs?